Last night all I think about is you. Don't stop, baby, you can walk too. Don't want, baby, think about you. You know that I'm never gonna lose.
YouTube channel. I hope you guys are having a splendid day. I feel like I wear the sweatshirt in every single one of my videos. Promise you I change out of it. I remember I had that like one shirt I used to wear in like every single one of my videos, and it looked like I never changed my clothes. It's just I wear it so much. I don't know. Same with the sweatshirt. But anyway, let's jump right into this video because it is going to be a little bit longer. It is 11 things rabbits hate. I did a guinea pig video on this, I think. I did a love and a hate. Maybe I'll do the same thing, I don't know. I have my Chromebook because I have a lot of notes. I will be definitely going into detail without getting off topic. I'm going to try so hard to stay on topic for this video. Before we get started, like and subscribe, the usual, totally up to you, but it makes my day every single time. So leave a comment down below and wait for the emoji in this video. So let's jump right in. The first thing out of the 11 of rabbits hating, I guess you could say, is being lonely. Let me clarify something. I know one person didn't get mad at me, but just kind of left me a comment. I can't say, like, for the guinea pig videos, for this video, that this works for everybody's bunny, everybody's guinea pig, everybody's hamster. What I've learned from majority of websites, majority of YouTube channels, majority of, like, anything, is what I have in this Google Doc. It is not... So, I'm sorry if some guinea pigs do like baths. I'm sorry if your guinea pig does like a bath. I'm sorry if your bunny does like being lonely. I don't know what to tell you. If any of these do apply, then just ignore it. This is what I've learned off of various websites and various YouTube channels. So, I'm sorry if it doesn't apply to you. I do try my best to kind of make everybody included. But if your bunny happens to like being alone, or your guinea pig happens to like baths, after many websites have told me they don't, I can't really fix that. So if you have a special request for a video, definitely let me know. But this will not apply to everybody's bunny, everybody's hamster, everybody's bird, okay? Majority of this will, like cage sizing and stuff like that will, but some will not, and don't come at me. Okay, so the first thing is being lonely. I will be looking at my Chromebook a little, I'm sorry. Rabbits are very social, just like us. We need to be around people, at least a lot of people need to be around people to be happy and social, even if it's your parents, your siblings, your cousins, whatever. They should be able to socialize with other people, including their owners or family and rabbits. So if your friend has a rabbit, or if you want to get a second rabbit, that is always a good idea, but you definitely need to make sure they're able to free roam, especially with more than one rabbit, as cages will get way too small. They have a unique language that is only spoken by other rabbits. So we cannot speak rabbit. Just like rabbit cannot speak English or any language that you speak. If you don't want to get another bunny, then you need to make sure you are there for your bunny. Meaning, if they are bored, you need to play with them, or if they want your attention, you have to give it to them. You can't just be out of your house 24/7 and not spend time with them if they don't have a companion. The second thing is loud music or noises. I kind of feel like this goes for any creature. I doubt there is really a house pet out there that loves loud music or startling noises. Rabbits can hear. They have really big ears, as you guys can tell. Their range of hearing is 360 hertz to 49,000 hertz. We can only hear 64 hertz to 23,000. So they have more than double of ours, which is crazy. So definitely if you were playing music and it's high, definitely if your bunny is around, turn it down if you think it's loud, because they will probably be blasting their eardrums off. Get away from that. Come here. Come here. Anyway, they can hear from 1.8 miles away. That is crazy. So say, like, well, I don't really have a good example for that. It's kind of easy to understand, but that is crazy. So imagine if your bunny is right next to a radio, or the radio is right, like, on the kitchen or something. Radio, you know what I mean. Any electronic that is playing music. It's probably very, very, very loud for them. So definitely be cautious of what music you're playing and not to startle them. So yeah, be careful with loud music or very high-pitched noises. Going to the vet is the third one. I doubt anybody out there wakes up and is like, oh, we get to go to the vet today. I doubt any person is like that who likes getting stabbed with needles and being touched everywhere. Rabbits hate it too. So try to get a good vet that cares about bunnies, that specializes in bunnies, and is patient with your bunny, because, I mean, it's weird. And bunnies don't know what's going on with all the beeping in the room, or just vets listening to heartbeats or putting casts on legs. I mean, they don't know what we're doing, so definitely get a vet that cares about your bunny and will be there if your bunny is hurt. Here's the emoji for this video. I hope you guys did enjoy. Comment the emoji down below, and I will see you guys in another video. Bye!